Hey guys, what is up? Today we're doing something a little bit different. I am sitting outside of Trader Joe's for the very first time. I'm so excited. I've got my mask, got my gloves, my wet wipes. I'm prepared and I'm going to show you guys what's in the store, as well as I will do a little haul when I get home. Please make sure to like, comment, subscribe. I love engaging with you guys. People are staring at me talking to you guys in my car. So yeah, peace out. I just took all of my makeup off. I've just wiped and sanitized everything, including my phone, so I'm sorry if my camera looks a little funky. But yeah, that was a very productive and very affordable trip. I'm so excited. I can't wait to get home and show you guys everything I got. So that's where I'm headed right now with my goods in the back. They were so sweet. I told them it was my first time and they gave me a free bag. So thoroughly impressed. We'll definitely be back. And I will head home right now and show you guys what I got. Okay, so we're back at my house. And first thing I wanna start off with is I'm so excited I found this because I haven't been able to find it anywhere, but I found some hand sanitizer at Trader Joe's. So I picked up a jug for us and I picked up a jug for my dad because I know he's running low. Because it's lemon scented, 70% alcohol and made with vitamin E. And this was $3.99, so not bad for 12 ounces a piece of a hand sanitizer. Another fresh thing that I picked up was some strawberries, and we have had horrible luck with strawberries this year so far. I think I've bought them the last 3 weeks in a row, and they just get really moldy really, really fast, so not good. These smell amazing and seem to be like super fresh, so fingers crossed with those. And this was a pound for $2.79. The next super popular thing that I got that I was really, really excited for, and a lot of people actually recommended me getting this, and that is the Trader Joe's Everything But the Bagel seasoning. And I'm really excited to eat this with my teeny tiny avocados because I actually eat avocado toast almost every morning for breakfast. I'm just obsessed with it. And I usually put like garlic salt on top of it. So tomorrow morning, I'll be trying out these. The Everything But the Bagel seasoning was $1.99. And the 6 count bag of the teeny tiny avocados was $2.99. The next thing that I got was something that actually I needed to repurchase because we were out of, and I needed some olive oil. So I picked up this Trader Joe's organic extra virgin olive oil, the Mediterranean blend. I wonder if this will taste different or something, but I'm gonna try this. This was actually $3.99, which I think is a pretty good deal considering it's organic. And then the next thing I'm gonna tell you guys about before we start getting to the exciting stuff in the freezer that I found. I found these Rainbow Gems fingerling potatoes, and I love the little purple potatoes, but the little bags of them that are at Food Lion and Harris Teeter and stuff like that, they only have like 3 purple potatoes in the entire bag. These appear to have quite a few, which I'm really excited to roast these. So now let's move on to the freezer section. Oh, before I get started though, these beautiful flowers that I actually got over here are for my mom because we're finally gonna get to see and spend some time with my mom this weekend. I got her some flowers because I miss her and I didn't get to see her for Mother's Day or her birthday. So I hope she likes them, and I know she's gonna watch this video. So spoiler alert, I'm gonna say the price of the flowers. They were $5.99, which I think is a really good deal. So if you're ever in the market for getting someone some flowers for something, go to Trader Joe's. Now, let's start the freezer stuff. The first thing I got is this Mexican style roasted corn with cotija cheese. This was $3.29 and you can cook it in the skillet or the microwave, and it just looks really, really delicious. And we love Mexican food in this house, and I thought this would be a good side, so got this. And then the next thing was highly, highly recommended, and I think this is one of their most popular products, but I'm really excited to try this because I'm recently on an Asian food kick as well, which never thought I would be, but I am. I picked up a bag of Trader Joe's Mandarin Orange Chicken. This was actually $4.99, and it's a huge bag, over a pound of orange chicken. Let me know in the comments if you guys have tried it, because I'm very excited. A dessert that I was really excited to find and I've never tried, but I know it's pretty popular and trendy right now, is mochi. I don't know how to say it, but I picked up some strawberry mochi, that's what I'm gonna call it, and this was $4.99. It's strawberry ice cream surrounded by sweet rice dough. But yeah, this just sounded really good because it's a nice cold, refreshing light snack. The next thing I got was just a basic refill. I just picked up some Trader Joe's frozen broccoli. This is a pound of broccoli for $1.69. One of the next kind of cool things I got was Trader Joe's chicken fried rice, which I've actually heard a lot about. This and the orange chicken I thought would be a good meal one night, a good easy meal. So I picked this up, and this was $2.99, I believe. Yep, $2.99. And yeah. The next two things I'm gonna show you guys are two pizzas that I picked up. I picked up their, I think, most famous signature pizza, margarita pizza. I feel like that's a little redundant, but I picked this up, as well as the pizza parmigiano. I think that's how you say it. It's a pizza with Italian sausage, pepperoni, peppers, and onions, which sounds like right up my alley. I think this is actually what we're gonna have for dinner tonight. The margarita pizza was $3.99, and the pizza with all the meat and peppers and onions was $4.99, which I don't think is a horrible deal for some big pizzas. Another exciting item that I found, these jerk chicken thigh skewers that are actually already on the skewer. You cook them on the grill, and they come with mango chutney on the side. Really excited to try these because I love jerk chicken. It's definitely got some heat to it, but it's good. It's got also that sweetness of, I guess, the mango and pineapple and stuff. This was $5.49, and I think this will be a good dinner for outside on the grill one night. Another super basic, not very interesting thing that I picked up was some oat milk, because I love oat milk. I don't really drink regular milk at all. Picked this up for $3.99. Another cool side dish that I found was this chimichurri rice for $2.99. Yeah, $2.99, because I picked up some Mexican food in here that I'll show you guys. Oh, here they are. I picked up these chipotle vegetable quesadillas because we love Mexican food in this house, and I thought this would be a good dinner combo one night. And this chimichurri rice was $2.99. The chipotle vegetable quesadillas were $3.49, so I don't think it was a horrible deal for some easy dinner weeknight recipes. Another super yummy thing that I'm excited to try, and it's a dessert, is this peaches and cream tart. My husband loves peach cobbler, so I thought this would kind of be a interesting twist on that. Please let me know if you guys have ever had this. I wonder if it's new. This was $5.49. Another kind of basic repurchase, even though I've never purchased it from Trader Joe's before, but another basic pantry fridge staple thing that I picked up was this vanilla Greek yogurt, and I actually picked up organic non-fat French vanilla Trader Joe's Greek yogurt. It was a really good deal. It was only $3.49 for this big thing of organic yogurt, which I feel like the stony filled organic yogurt at the other grocery stores can be pretty pricey. Moving on to another yummy side and something interesting that I've never had before are these roasted potatoes with peppers and onions from Trader Joe's. Apparently they're already cooked and you basically just have to heat them through. I love potatoes, so I thought that this would be a good side with some chicken. And these are only $2.99. Two other popular Trader Joe's items that I was excited to try because I've heard a lot of buzz about them were the gnocchi. I think that's how you say it, gnocchi. Please don't be mad at me if I say that wrong. I'm not the best at pronunciating things. Pronouncing things. I'm not the best at that. So I got cauliflower gnocchi and kale gnocchi, and these were both $2.69 a piece. Excited to try. Please let me know if you have. Another popular item that I've seen everywhere that I decided I wanted to try for myself too are these chicken cilantro lime mini wontons. I've heard a lot about these, and these were $2.99. Yeah, picked these up. The next thing I'm probably irrationally excited for, but I've really been into carrots lately. Now, I know that's a weird statement, but I've just been really craving like avocado, watermelon, and carrots lately. Like, I guess because it's summertime and it's like fresh stuff. But I picked up these colorful carrot coins, and it's pretty much just diced colorful carrots. There's orange, yellow, white, and purple carrots, which I had no idea there was even carrots of those colors, but I picked these up. But yeah, these were $2.99 for 14 ounces of colorful carrot coins. I don't know why that was so hard for me to say. Yeah, I'm excited to try these. Now, the last three things that I've got to show you guys are, I think, pretty cool, but maybe these are more mainstream Trader Joe's items. But I picked up the Trader Joe's butternut squash ravioli. I have never had anything like this before. I usually stick with just cheese ravioli, but I thought this would be a good way to kind of get extra veggies added in. And like I said earlier, an easy dinner. Throw some Alfredo sauce on here, throw some red sauce on here, something, and you've got dinner with a salad, you know, easy. And these were actually $2.99. I think that's a pretty good deal for some fresh butternut squash. So yeah, pick these up. The last two things I picked up are smoothies. So I'll just show you guys these all at the same time. I picked up two Trader Joe's brand smoothies. I picked up this banana and almond butter protein smoothie with coconut water and pea protein. It says it has 14 grams of protein in this drink and 320 calories for the whole bottle. So I guess this would kind of be more so like a meal replacement kind of a thing. And on the other end of the spectrum, I got a cold pressed Trader Joe's juice. I love my green juices. I'm weird. I really love vegetables, and I'm learning to like fruit a lot. So this is a good way to get that in. So I picked up this green juice, and this is 100 calories for the entire bottle and has 17 kale leaves, a pound of spinach, holy crap, one large apple, a quarter of an English cucumber, one celery stalk, one lemon, and 2 inches of ginger. So I'm hoping it's not like too spicy because of the ginger, but I'm excited to drink these. I love smoothies. These were also $2.99 and $3.99. Sorry, almost forgot to say that. But yeah, that concludes my Trader Joe's haul. First adventure into the Trader Joe's world. And I can see what all the rave is about. I really, really like it. I think I will definitely be back. If you guys have any Trader Joe's products I should keep in mind or try to look for, please let me know down below. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and turn on that notification bell. And I will see you guys for my next video.